One person just says 5, 6, 7, 8.
There's always cliques. There's usually a jock crowd. There's usually like a skater crowd. There's like a punk crowd. What's cool about this movie is we sort of break out of those and everyone sort of mingles.
It's just about being yourself and showing other people who you really are, expressing yourself and saying, you know what? I'm going to be who I am and who I want to be and not what everyone else tells me that I am.
When people break out into song and dance after watching that, it gives you this energy, this rush, and it's so fascinating to watch.
It's like when you're driving around in a car and the music comes on and your whole everything just changes. We always create a soundtrack to our lives and wish that we could have a musical, you know, about us.
I for one would love to all of a sudden, out of nowhere, just break out into song and dance.
This movie has every kind of music.
There is hip hop, there is
salsa, Broadway show tunes,
contemporary,
jazz,
pop, samba,
ballads. It's not just the same song over and over again.
Over 600 boys and girls auditioned for the movie. The process for the actors, it was not like a traditional audition because they had to be able to act, they had to be able to sing, they had to be able to dance, and they had to be able to connect all three of those ideas and really bring forth an exciting and fun character and performance.
For the callbacks, there was about 12 girls up for my role. The process took all day, and we all sang all day, and we danced all day, and we did our scene, and it got down to 4. And me and Zach got paired up every single time. So I was like, well, hopefully this is a good thing.
Once we cast the actors, we then began our recording sessions.
We go in and sing the song the way that we heard it on the demo. Sometimes we would add different parts just to make it sound like there's a whole bunch of people, which there will be.
I recorded it and I got my CD back and I'm like listening to myself. I'm like, my gosh, that's me. I've never heard myself sing, and I sound good, and I'm proud of myself.
From there, they flew into Salt Lake. We had a big table read where we read the entire script with all of the characters for the first time. It was like the first day all of the actors were present, and we played all of that music as we were going through the reading so that everybody got an idea of how the music integrated into our storytelling. And then we went into rehearsals.
Oh, well, normally for a movie, you show up and you immediately start filming. For this one, we show up and we have 2 weeks of intense dance rehearsals.
Left foot, that's the key. Step forward to the left foot. Left, now lean back. It's shoulder, hand, shoulder, back. Feet tight. Cool.
On top of that, I had like 3 hours of basketball practice a day.
Not very good.
Most of the time, you know, when you rehearse for dance, you show up, the choreographer says, okay, here's the moves, this is how you do it, now do it. And this was completely different. And that's mainly because of Kenny.
Kenny is a character. Kenny is the heart of this movie. I mean, he's directing, he's choreographing.
And in my case, being a choreographer, I get to invent the dances. And I get to work with the music folks in the development of the music.
Right. One more time.
Basically, he put on the CD and he said, show me what you have, guys. Just do it. Let's have fun. Let's experiment.
Most directors, you walk up and you say, hey, how's it going? They give you a very polite handshake and a good morning. Kenny, you walk up to him and he's like, what's up? How's it going, dude? You know, he just is, his mannerisms and everything about him, he's just a kid. I don't know, he has this creative way about him that makes everyone listen and respect him very much.
I have two incredible associate choreographers. Bonnie Story, who I worked with in Salt Lake, Utah on the Olympics, and Chucky, who is an incredible hip-hop dancer and choreographer from Los Angeles, choreographer of the LA Sparks.
You know, Charles and I have been in the studio together working on something before Kenny walks in, and Charles will say to me, well, how do you think this works? And then I'll do it, and I'll feel it, and I'll go, okay, how about this? And then he'll take it another step, and then I'll take it another step.
And in the end, it's a team effort, yeah. And we've all of a sudden created something amazing. And then there's the basketball choreography, which is my favorite part. It's fun. It's basketball. We work with a coach for some of the choreography because there are set plays that we have to run based on the lyrics of the verses.
The scene Get Your Head in the Game, it's a scene about basketball where we incorporate some dancing with it. So it gives these guys a chance to let out all the energy, bounce around more, at the same time throw in some of their dance skills into the basketball rhythm. A very, very fun and exciting piece.
Everyone makes it look so easy on screen. It's hard to dance and at the same time keep your mouth moving and singing the words. And you get winded, you get tired.
You actually have to be really fit to do it because you get so out of breath.
My feet hurt. Don't look at my feet. They're all battered and torn up.
And our job is to make it look easy on screen, make it look like we're flowing. And a lot of work goes into that behind the scenes.
Go, 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 go!
Status quo. It's basically madness. The jocks have their own table, the brainiacs, the skater dudes. Everyone has their own section of the cafeteria that they sit at.
What's up?
Everything gets crazy when people start mingling with each other away from their own group. So you have brainiacs with their books going up to jocks, and the jocks reading their books and thinking, wow, cool. And then a cheerleader starts skating, and it looks like madness, but every single second is choreographed.
Yeah, I thought she should come this way and come up here, you know.
Every person has a specific move or reaction that they have to do, and none of it is just someone moving to move.
Everything has to be right straight down to the last move, because if it's not, then it looks sloppy. Why make it look sloppy when you can have it fabulous?
Status quo.
Have everyone singing these songs in their head because they're already stuck in my head, and I've been doing a good amount.
Together, 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 it just needs to be about communicating and connecting with each other.